thank you for the opportunity to come and worship you before your throne. Thank you for your word that we're able to explain and declare it to your people. We pray for our parents today. We pray that you save them, that you cause them to believe the Bible and submit to the authority of the Bible. We pray that our parents would be good instructors of our children, instructing them in the way of the Lord and in the way of salvation. Bless and confirm your word now, we pray, by Christ's authority. Amen. A father's warning against sin. A father's warning against sin. Our text is Proverbs chapter 1, verses 8 through 10. We will return to this passage as we develop this message. Beloved, this is the first of many fatherly talks in the book of Proverbs. In this first fatherly talk, we have a warning against sin. Parents, who taught you to successfully deal with temptation and sin? Whose job it is to teach your children to successfully deal with temptation and sin? Seriously now, from which source are your children receiving their instruction to deal with temptation and sin? The TV, social media, their peers? Parents, Proverbs chapter 1 informs us as to where children are to get their instruction to successfully handle temptation and sin. So let's look at this passage carefully. Proverbs 1, 8 through 10. What do we find? Firstly, parents are our first defense against temptation and sin. Praise God. Sir, listen to Proverbs chapter 1, verses 8 through 10. It says, "Listen, my son, to your father's instruction, and do not forsake your mother's teaching. They are a garland of grace to your head and a chain to adorn your neck. My son, if sinful men entice you, do not give in to them." Praise God. Parents, we have three great thoughts here. What are they? One, parents must speak God's word to their children, and children must obey God's word to successfully combat temptation and sin. Amen. Parents, do you realize that you represent God in the lives of your children? Almighty God has given you authority to lead and to parent your children using His word, the Bible. Now, parents, do you believe in Almighty God? Do you believe God's word, the Bible? Do you instruct your children using the Bible? Are you instructing your children to handle temptation and sin using the Holy Bible? Beloved, we have a beautiful example in Scripture as to how this works. In 2 Timothy chapter 1 and 5, the great apostle Paul said to Timothy, the young preacher, "I am reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice, and I am persuaded now lives in you also." Praise God. And in 2 Timothy 3 and 15, the great apostle Paul said to this young man, "And now from infancy you have known the holy scriptures, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus." Hear this, beloved. The grandmother of Timothy taught his mother the word of God. His mother taught him the word of God. to the point where he experienced salvation by faith in Jesus Christ, believed the Holy Scripture, and learned how to deal successfully with temptation and sin. Glory to God. Now, we have some idiots and stupid persons in this country who are opposed to us passing on our Christian faith and beliefs to our children, saying that we must not give our Christian faith and beliefs to our children, but must wait until they are grown to choose what they want to believe. Sir, if these people believe this nonsense, then why stop it at the Christian faith and biblical beliefs? They must take it all the way. With regard to their children's education, they must say, we will not choose education for our children, but leave them until they are grown to decide whether they want an education or not. With regard to their children's health and nutrition, they should say, let the children eat whatever they want as small children and wait until they are grown to decide whether they want to eat healthily or not. Neighbor, do you see how absurd these people are? Why? These are the same people who complain about young people's sinful activities when they didn't take the time to teach them the Word of God that would prevent them from engaging in sinful activities. Parents, here are two passages of Scripture you must take note of. Deuteronomy chapter 6, 4 through 7 says, hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts. Hear it now. Impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, when you lie down and when you get up. Parents, teach your children the Bible. Impress on them the truths of the Bible. Psalm 78, 3, 4, and 6 states, things we have heard and known, things our ancestors have told us, we will not hide them from their descendants. We will tell the next generation the praiseworthy deeds of the Lord, his power, and the wonders he has done. Hear it. So the next generation may know, even the children yet to be born, and they in turn tell their children. Glory to God. Christian parents, pass on your Christian faith and beliefs to your children so that they can successfully deal with temptation and sin and this evil world system that is under the control of the devil. Secondly, notice the certain or sure reward of obeying God's word. Proverbs 1 and 9 states, they are a garland to grace your head and a chain to adorn your neck, children. When you obey your parents' instruction and teaching, which is from God, you will be rewarded for your obedience. Two things you will have in your life when you obey God's word given to you by your parents. One, a garland of grace on your head. Two, a chain of wisdom to adorn your neck. In other words, when you obey God Almighty by doing what he commands, God will shower grace or favor into your life, and he will also give you heavenly wisdom. Children, an amplified description of what you will have for obeying your parents is stated in Ephesians chapter 6, verses 1, 2, and 3. We are told, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Honor your father and mother, which is the first commandment with a promise, so that it may go well with you and that you may enjoy long life on the earth. Praise God. Children, your parents are to give you biblical instructions. That biblical instruction, you are to obey. When you obey biblical instruction, you will be empowered to deal successfully with temptation and sin. You will be empowered to deal with negative peer pressure and this evil world system that is controlled by the devil. In other words, receive, retain, and practice biblical instruction, and you will prolong, protect, and preserve your life. Glory to God. Thirdly, notice the correct response to temptation and sin. Young people, Proverbs chapter 1, verse 10 and 15 states, my son, if sinful men entice you, do not give in to them. Verse 15, my son, do not go along with them. Do not set foot on their paths. Children, let's define our terms. What is temptation? Temptation is a difficult situation, a pressure that brings a reaction through which the character or commitment of a person is demonstrated, said Lawrence Richards. Brother, do you successfully overcome your temptations? When you are placed under pressure by temptation, do you stay true to biblical truth? Do you stay true to the Lord Jesus Christ? And do you stay true to your commitment? Well, what is sin? Sin is any thought, word, attitude, or action that misses God's moral target or standard. This is why Romans 3 and 23 states, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God or the moral standard of God. Young people, God's moral standard is the Holy Bible. In the Bible, God gave us the target we are to aim at every time. We are to aim at worshiping Almighty God alone. We are to aim at loving God and people always. In our relationships, we are to aim at dealing with people in ways that are right and just and fair. We are to aim at being upright, blameless, just, and faithful in God's sight. Amen. Friend, every time we sin, we miss God's target or moral standard and need immediate forgiveness from God. Thank God. 1 John 1:9 informs us, if we confess our sins, He, God, is faithful and just and will forgive us our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Children, how do we correctly deal with temptation and sin? Listen to Proverbs 1 and 10 again. My son, if sinful men entice you, do not give in to them. When sinners tempt you, what do? You do not consent. You do not give in. Young people, when Daniel was tempted to eat food and drink wine offered to idols, he said no. When the three Hebrew boys were tempted to worship King Nebuchadnezzar's idol, they said no. When Joseph, son of Jacob, was tempted to have sex with his master's wife, he said no. When the Lord Jesus Christ was tempted by the devil to use his power to make bread, to jump off a high roof, and to worship the devil, he said no. Beloved, nothing is wrong with saying no to sin, but everything is wrong to say yes to sin. Children, why do you reject temptations and sin? Because you want to honor Almighty God with your life. You want to avoid destroying your life, your character, reputation, and disgracing your family. You want to keep your commitment to Christ and biblical truth. You want to keep guilt out of your life. You want to be a glowing example for others to follow. You want to prove that God's amazing and infinite grace and power, they are able to keep you holy in this sinful world. You want to avoid grieving, quenching, and resisting the Holy Spirit by sinning against Him. Beloved, do not give in to sin. Do not consent to sinners. Fight sin. Resist sin. Defeat sin. Remember that as a believer in Christ, you died to sin. Therefore, put to death sin in your life and live only for the Lord Jesus Christ. Remember now, true victory over temptation and sin you will have when you experience the saving grace of Almighty God. Those of you who are not saved from sin and the wrath of God, God loves you. Christ died in your place for all of your sins. Right now, if you repent of your sins and you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, God will forgive you all your sins as you confess them. And He will break the power of sin and temptation over your life. And above all, He will adopt you into His family, making you a child of God. And you will possess eternal life starting right now. So why not turn to Christ? Believe Him. Obey Him. Make Him your Savior and Lord. Father, this is your word. You said it will not return void unto you, but will accomplish its purpose for which you have sent it forth. So accomplish your purpose for which you have sent forth this word today. We pray by Christ's authority. Amen.